हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी कवर द टॉपिक बेस्ड ऑन कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ स्क्यूनेस एंड कर्टोसिस बेस्ड ऑन मोमेंट्स। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर यू ऑलरेडी सॉ कार्ल पियर्सन कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ स्क्यूनेस एंड बाउलेस कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ स्क्यूनेस एंड एग्जांपल बेस्ड ऑन दैट। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद दिस लेक्चर। Pearson measure of skewness based on moments. It is denoted by gamma 1. And what is gamma 1? Gamma 1 is nothing but the square root of beta 1. And beta 1 is mu 3 square divided by mu 2 cube. What is mu 3? Mu 3 is nothing but the third central moment. And mu 2 is nothing but the second central moment. So, interpretation based on that is what? If the gamma 1 greater than 0 or if mu 3 greater than 0, in that case we say that the distribution is positively skewed. If gamma 1 less than 0 and mu 3 is also less than 0, we say the distribution is negatively skewed. If gamma 1 is equals to 0 and mu 3 is equals to 0, the distribution is symmetric. So, these are the three interpretation of the gamma 1. Now, see here one note. The sign of gamma 1 depends on the sign of mu 3. To calculate gamma 1, we first find mu 3, that is third central moment. If third central moment is negative, in that case, the answer of gamma 1, we give sign negative. If mu 3 is positive, then answer of gamma 1 is also positive. So, sign of gamma 1 depends on sign of mu 3. Now, here is one example of Pearson measure of skewness. So, what is my data? Data is 2, 3, 8, 4, 10 and 6. So, see here, we first calculate here second and third central moment. For that, I create here one table which include xi, x square and x cube, and then we find the summation of all these values. So first, addition of xi 33, xi square 229 and xi cube 1827. So third central moment formula is what? Summation xi cube upon n. Summation xi cube is what? 1287 divided by n, that is 6. So final answer is 304.5. Now what is mu 2? Mu 2 is summation xi square upon n. Xi square is 229 divided by n, that is 6. We get here 38.1667. So, beta 1 is mu 3 square divided by mu 2 cube. So, mu 3 square is what? 304.5 square divided by mu 2, 38.1667 cube. So, final answer is 1.6677. So, gamma 1 is what? The square root of beta 1. So, final answer of gamma 1 is 1.2914. So, this value is greater than 0. Therefore, we write the distribution is positively skewed. Measure of kurtosis based on moment. Now see, sometimes what happened? We required the complete idea about the distribution. In that case, measure of central tendency, dispersion and skewness are not sufficient to get idea about the complete distribution. Means what? Sometimes the data have same mean, standard deviation, same amount of skewness, but to compare that data, they may be differ in their relative height of the frequency curve. So, Carl Pearson suggests a measure based on relative of the frequency curve. It is referred as kurtosis. So see here, to get the complete idea about the distribution, measure of central tendency, measure of dispersion and the skewness are not sufficient. So two symmetric distribution have the same mean, same standard deviation and same amount of skewness, but they may differ in their relative height of the frequency curve. So Professor Carl Pearson suggested a measure of relative of frequency curve. It is known as simply kurtosis. So how to define the kurtosis? The kurtosis defined as the property of distribution which express the flatness or the relative peakedness of the frequency curve. So mainly based on this definition, there are three types of kurtosis: mesokurtic, leptokurtic and platykurtic. So see here one diagram. When my diagram is at middlemost position, it is called as what? Mesokurtic. And what is definition? See here definition. The distribution having peakedness equal to that of the normal distribution are called as mesokurtic. When my diagram is look like a normal distribution, it is simply called as the mesokurtic. If distribution having more peak than that of the normal distribution. See, this is the normal distribution. If my diagram is above the normal distribution, it is called as what? Leptokurtic. If the distribution having less peak than that of the normal distribution, then distribution is called as platykurtic. If my diagram is less than that of normal distribution, it is simply called as platykurtic. So mainly there are three types of diagram: leptokurtic, mesokurtic and the platykurtic. So the measure of kurtosis. Now see here the measure of skewness based on movements. It is denoted by gamma 1. While the measure of kurtosis based on movements is simply denoted by gamma 2, and the formula is given by beta 2 minus 3. So what is beta 2? Fourth central movement divided by second central movement square. So what is interpretation? Beta 2 greater than 3, that is gamma 2 greater than 0, the distribution is leptokurtic. If beta 2 is equals to 3 and gamma 2 is equals to 0, the distribution is mesokurtic. If beta 2 less than 3 and gamma 2 also less than 0, the distribution is platykurtic. So for greater value, leptokurtic. If gamma 2 is equals to 0, the mesokurtic. And gamma 2 less than 0, the distribution simply called as the platykurtic. So always remember, the gamma 2 and beta 2 are free from the units, and gamma 2 always greater than or is equals to 1, and beta 2 is always greater than or is equals to 1, and beta 2 greater than or is equals to beta 1 plus 1. So I will repeat it again. Measure of skewness based on movements. Okay, that is denoted by gamma 1. Kurtosis, it is denoted by gamma 2. This is what? This is coefficient of skewness. This is called as skewness, while this is called as kurtosis. Both are based on movements. What is formula for coefficient of skewness? It is simply gamma 1, which is square root of what? Beta 1. While kurtosis formula is gamma 2 is equals to what? Beta 2 minus 3. Okay, what is interpretation? If gamma 1 greater than 0, distribution is positively skewed. Gamma 1 less than 0, distribution is negatively skewed. and gamma 1 is equals to 0, distribution is symmetric. Gamma 2 greater than 0, distribution is leptocratic. Gamma 2 less than 0, distribution is platycratic. And gamma 2 is equals to 0, distribution is mesocratic. And what is relation between gamma 1 and beta 1 and beta 2? Beta 2 is always greater than or is equals to beta 1 plus 1, and beta answer of beta 2 is greater than or is equals to 1. What is the formula for gamma 1? Gamma 1 formula for beta 1. Beta 1 is what? It is simply third central moment square divided by second central moment cube. And what is formula for beta 2? It is simply fourth central moment divided by second central moment square. So this is the differentiate between gamma 1 and gamma 2. So here is one example. Define kurtosis based on given data. So which data is given? The first four raw moments are given. Always remember, the raw moments are denoted by mu r dash, while central moment is denoted by what? It is denoted by mu r, where r take value from 1 to up to 4. So here raw moments are given. So see here, mu 1 dash 2, mu 2 dash 20, mu 3 dash 40, and mu 4 dash 200. Okay. Now we want to find here what kurtosis. So what is formula for kurtosis? Gamma 2, which is beta 2 minus 3. And what is beta 2? The fourth central moment divided by second central moment square. Now see here, the central moment is given. Sorry, we have to find central moments using raw moments. So we use here relationship between central moment and raw moments to find the answer of the central moment. So what is relation between central moments and raw moments? So see here, second central moment is equals to second raw moment minus first raw moment square. So mu 2 dash minus mu 1 1 dash square. So what is mu 2 dash? 20 minus mu 1 1 dash 2. So our final answer is 16. And what is mu 4? It is mu 4 dash minus 4 mu 3 dash mu 1 1 dash plus 6 mu 2 dash mu 1 1 dash square minus 3 mu 1 1 dash raised to 4. Put all these values of raw moment. So final answer of fourth central moment is what? 3 1 2. So answer of second central moment 16, and answer of fourth central moment is 312. So put here value of mu 4 and mu 2. So what I get? 1.21188. So beta 2 minus 3. So 1.21188 minus 3. So final answer is minus 1.7812. This value is what? It is less than 0. Okay, so what we write? We write here comment, the distribution is platycratic. For less than value, it is always platycratic. Next example, the variance of the distribution is 14. What should be the value of four central moments so that the distribution is mesocratic and the leptocratic? Now variance is given. So what is variance? It is denoted by sigma square, and variance is also called as second central moment. So sigma square is equals to mu 2, which is what? 14. Now we have to find your value of fourth central moment, that is mu 4. Now what they given? When first one, the distribution is mesocratic. In case of mesocratic, see here, if the distribution is mesocratic, always the value of beta 2 is what? 3. But what is beta 2? It is mu 4 divided by mu 2 square, which is equals to 3. So mu 4 is equals to 3 into 196. Okay, so mu 4 is 588. So we just here put the value of mu 2 to get the answer of mu 4. Similarly, now distribution is what? Leptokurtic. In case of leptokurtic, beta 2 is always greater than or is equal greater than 3. What is beta 2 again? It is mu 4 divided by mu 2 square greater than 3. We have to find here mu 4, so put value of mu 2 square, that is 196. So mu 4 greater than 588, that is the answer. So in case of mesokurtic, the fourth central moment is 588, and in case of leptokurtic, the fourth central moment is greater than 588. Next, a distribution has mean 30. Arithmetic mean is given, coefficient of variation is given, that is 20%, and coefficient of skewness is given, that is 0.3. We have to find here mode. Now, which information is given? First, we use this information, the coefficient of variation means CV is given. So, what is formula for CV? Sigma divided by X bar into 100. CV is given, 20. Is equals to sigma divided by arithmetic mean means what? X bar is given. So we put in this formula. So 20 is equals to sigma divided by 30 into 100. So what is sigma? Answer of sigma after solving this is 6. Further, the coefficient of skewness we use here, which is what? X bar minus mode divided by sigma. Now, why we use that formula? Because this information is given, the coefficient of skewness. So, use formula for coefficient of skewness. Now, solve this equation. Put the value of x bar and sigma. In this case, we will get here mode. So, x bar is 30, sigma 6 is equals to 0.3. So, 30 minus mode is equals to 1.8. So, mode is what? 28.2. So we first hear information of CV, and secondly we go for the formula for coefficient of skewness, and final answer of mode is what? That is 28.2. Thank you.